When setting up your home network, one important question comes up. Should you rent or buy your modem and router? It's a decision that can affect not only your internet experience, but also your wallet.
Welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, I'm Melanie, broadband expert at Broadband Now, where we help those of you who want to save money on your internet service and equipment. In today's video, we're diving into the pros and cons of renting versus buying your modem and router. That way you can make the best decision for your home. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel for product reviews, helpful guides, data-backed research on broadband and the digital divide, industry news and trends, and more. Now, let's talk about the costs of modems and routers.
First, let's clarify what a modem and router actually do. Your modem is the device that connects your home to your internet service provider. It's responsible for translating digital signals from your ISP into something your devices can understand. Think of it as a bridge between the internet and your home network. On the other hand, a router distributes that internet connection to all the devices in your home. It creates a local network and, if it's a wireless router, it generates a Wi-Fi signal that your devices can connect to without needing any cables. Simply put, the modem brings the internet to your home and the router makes it accessible to all your devices. Some ISPs offer a combo device that acts as both a modem and a router, which can simplify things, but also has its own set of pros and cons. When you rent a modem and router from your ISP, it usually costs between $10 to $15 per month. Over a year, that adds up to about $120 to $180. Renting a modem and router doesn't cost too much, but buying one outright can be more cost-effective in the long run. However, some internet providers offer this equipment for free, which means renting might make more sense. One of the biggest advantages of renting is convenience. Your ISP handles everything from setup to technical support. If something goes wrong, they'll replace the equipment for free. Renting is also a great option for those in short-term living situations or for anyone who doesn't want to deal with the hassle of managing their own devices. But there are some downsides. Monthly rental fees can add up over time, and you don't own the equipment, meaning you can't use it if you switch ISPs. Plus, there's a chance you might end up with outdated hardware, which could slow down your internet experience. What about buying your own modem and router? The upfront cost is higher. You're looking at an average of around $127 for a modem alone, and even more if you want a top-of-the-line router. But here's the key point. Once you buy it, it's yours. No more monthly fees. Buying gives you more control over your network. You can choose a high-performance router that meets your specific needs, like a mesh Wi-Fi system for better coverage or a gaming router for faster speeds. And since you own the equipment, you can take it with you if you switch ISPs, assuming it's compatible. However, buying also comes with its own set of challenges. You'll need to handle any tech issues on your own or hire someone to help, which could mean additional costs. Plus, there's the risk that your equipment might not be compatible with the new ISP, especially if you want to move to an area with a different type of internet service.
So, how do you decide whether to rent or buy? It really comes down to your personal situation. Here are a few things to consider.
First, consider your budget. Renting is easier on your wallet in the short term, but buying can save you money in the long run. Next, think about how long you plan to stay in one place. If you're planning to move soon, renting might be more practical. But if you're settled in and want the latest technology, investing in your own equipment might be the better option. Another factor is the level of control and performance you want. If you're tech savvy and want the best possible network performance, buying gives you more options to customize your setup. On the other hand, if you prefer a simple, hassle-free experience, renting might be the way to go.
So, you should think about your budget, how long you plan to stay, and your tech preferences. If you want the latest technology and plan to stay put, buying might be the way to go. But if you're looking for convenience and support, renting could be your best bet. Just make sure, either way, in whatever direction you go, it's a good fit for you and it keeps you connected. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, give us a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more tips on saving money on your internet service and equipment. You can read our guide on broadbandsnow.com. The link is right there in the description. Also, turn on those notifications so you don't miss out. We'll see you next time.